Hello, I'm Mr. Amitri, retired lecturer in metallurgy, a scientist. You haven't been to the University of University to study theology. I studied metallurgy, metals. And my father had the same interest, and I learned the basic from him. So Christianity is very simple and easy. Sikhism is continuation of Christianity, non-equality, second coming of Jesus. Here I render exposition of Matthew 19, verse 23 to 30. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi we say Satguru, Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., which is our supernatural father of our souls. This body is created by Yahweh, Brahma, Khuda, and the nature belongs to the demiurge, the soul inside our supernatural, which is not visible, which is supernatural, is from our supernatural father, Elohim, Allah Father. So Jesus came to deliver that message of our supernatural father. There are the rabbis, they were the moral teachers, they were teaching of the moral law pertaining to our body. And John the Baptist was prophet Elijah. My God is Yahweh, Yahweh Brahma Khuda. So Jesus said to his twice born laborers, Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. The natural boys were disciplined by the rabbis by teaching them the moral of Moses. So they have the disciples, not Jesus. Not the possible disciples of the rabbis. Amen. I say to you, it will be hard for one who is rich to enter the royal kingdom of Mammon. Royal kingdom of Mammon-Free God. The royal kingdom begins here. This is John the Baptist. He baptized the Jewish man in water in the name of Abraham. And he is holding scripture. And he has wings. He never baptized a woman, a Gentile, or a Samaritan, only the Jewish man. And those who were baptized, they were sensible. And they were looking for this narrow gate to the royal vineyard of our Father, which is above, this is below. So here, our soul is concerned, this is the royal vineyard of our supernatural father. So supernatural soul is concerned here, not body. In flesh you may be male or female, the Jew or Gentile, black or brown. Here your soul is concerned, that has no color, nothing like that. So here we are all sons of God. Women also are sons of God. So that's why Thomas said, unless a female is here, who do what the rabbi tells them to do, unless a female becomes a male, and enter the royal vineyard of our father, you cannot enter into the royal vineyard of our father unless a female becomes a male with Christ in his heart. Here they are Christ, not Christian. Christians are here, the people of the book, holding Bible and all that. So Bible is forbidden here, which is Jewish level. because your covenant is of Holy Spirit. Gospel is written over your heart. You don't need a Bible here. So this is my take. If anybody wants to improve it, I would appreciate it. Again, I say to you, it is easier for a camel, a serving animal. We are also animals, you know, our animal kingdom. Animal to pass through the eye of a needle. A camel, you know, he serves his master well. So if we serve our master, our father, well, we can enter into the kingdom of God. That's what Jesus said here, you know. It's easier for a camel, a serving animal, to pass through the eye of a needle, to become humble, you know. Humbly he is serving the master, you know. Go with him and look after him also. Then for one who is rich to enter the royal kingdom of God. The rich can't enter the royal kingdom of God, because St. Jesus said, when you go on a preaching tour, don't take any money in your pocket. Because here, this place is Mammon-Free. No money. No two shoes, no two tunic, etc. This is Mammon here. Secular people, celestial world, free of mammon. That's why Jesus said, don't take any mammon in your pocket, and no two shoe, no two tunic, and no script. Script means scripture, Bible, the Jewish level is forbidden in the royal kingdom of God. When his brother heard this, they were greatly astonished and said, who then can be saved? Because everybody carried money, you know. Jesus looked at them and said, for human beings, this is impossible. But for God and his sons, because son represents father, all things are possible. But once you become the sons of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., then everything is possible. And I was born in Mulsahan, who there is a grave of Shah Mr. Brady. And over there, the mullahs took off his skin. You know, they wanted to apply Sharia, and he said, okay. So they took off his skin. The Sharia applied to skin, and not to your heart. So he took off his skin, and he was, body was, you know, very bad looking. So he asked the people to cook fish for his friend, for his younger brother, who was the son of a king. And people refused, seeing the body of the Shashamsa the brains. He said, no, go away. Then he asked his son itself to come down and cook the fish of my brother. So son starts coming down. And then people made human cry. What I mean to say, supernatural father is greater than the natural father and the nature. So sun and star, they are part of the nature. Whatever you see with two naked eyes is all nature. So with supernatural power, you can bring them down. As Jesus said, if you ask a mountain to move from one place to other, it will move. possible. Then Krishna said to him in reply, we have given up everything and followed you. Now this is a very important statement that people, you know, at Matsu, when he joined hands with Jesus, half of his possessions, he gave it up, gave it to the poor before he joined with Jesus. So others also, you know, they have left their families because in Jesus, you need to be solitary and determined, not to be put a hand to the plow and then think back, you know. So they must say bye-bye to their mother and father, to their relatives, everything, nothing to do with like sadhus. In India, the sadhus, you know, when they leave their families, like they have nothing to do with them. So they are purely spiritual then. In spiritual, there is no caste or no tribal identity is essential. What will there be for us? Now here the picture was once born of the 12. So he did not understand, you know. So he was then worried, you know. And then at Pentecost, he called the very Spirit of God. He was the one who was very drunk with the old, with the new wine. And he started preaching gospel. That is what he got at the end. So, then, followed you, what will be there for us? Jesus said to them, Amen, I say to you that you who have joined hands with me and not followed blindly, or like a blind man, person, in the new age, when the Son of Man is seated on his throne of glory, will yourselves sit on the 12 thrones, judging the 12 tribes of Israel. This is bloody corruption. Jesus has nothing to do with the secular rule or anything. So, you can see, you know, for the Messianic Jew, they corrupted the New Testament as well. And everyone who has given up houses, our brothers, our sisters, our father, our mother, our children, our land, for the sake of my name, will receive a 100 times more. 100 times more is the perfect union with God. Remember that Jesus said in the parable of the sower, some seed fell on flat ground, some on rocky soil, someone saw it and he choked it, and one who fell on the soil, which was weed free, which is wilderness, and he produced 100%. That is what they got at Pentecost, the very reward of our supernatural Father, same Holy Spirit as Christ Jesus had. So they became the twin brother of Christ Jesus. So there is a corruption we have to be careful, you know. They don't know the difference between the kingdom of heaven and the royal kingdom of God. They are two different ones, you know. And here it is. This is my book, which I have written. And this is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the Rabbis. For it is usually outside, in the outside world. And this is in the royal kingdom of God, inside your heart. Inside your heart. Christianity is a heart. And not a dead book. That's why St. Paul said, the gospel is written over your heart. and that is incompatible as the scripture is, which is corruptible. So gospel is not corruptible once you get it through logical reasoning. This is my book, and you need to read it as well. So, as Jesus demonstrated in his receive a hundredfold, 100 times more, and will inherit eternal life, as Jesus demonstrated in his friend Lazarus. Lazarus was the first fruit of resurrection. But many who are first may be last. What applies to flesh, the opposite applies to spirit. In flesh, you know, if you employ somebody and he works 12 hours, you pay him for 12 hours. In spirit, if somebody joins at the last moment, opposite, you know, last moment, spent only quarter an hour, and he is the one who gets the first reward. The one who works for 10 hours or so, he will be the last one. Same reward, Holy Spirit. No more, no less. But many who are first will be last, and the last will be first. When our Father rewarded them at Pentecost. At Pentecost, when the one who was last chosen was Matthias. So Matthias received the reward first, and then the other people, according to their date of choosing. It's very interesting, it's very logical, and it all gets written here. Once you have Christ in your heart, you have Christ in your heart, you have to clean your temper of greed. If you're not greedy, then God rests in your heart. If greedy, Satan is here, God is out. So hypocrisy. If you are hypocrite, then you are nowhere near God. Take for example, Bush and Blair declared that Saddam Hussein has weapons of mass destruction. And we had Lieutenant General of the army who was in Iraq after the bombardment of so-and-so. So people asked him, you know, was there any weapon of mass destruction? He said, none at all. So it was 100% blasphemy. And they were blasphemous, and they went scot-free. Look what they did to Iraq and other countries, Libya and other countries, disturbance they have caused. So the man who shows through his both shoes and pushed, he's a hero. And that is how you should be, not fearing anyone. Queen, head of the Church of England, rich person. She can't enter into the royal kingdom of God, and saw how the people were subject to her in the Church of England, how they have entered. So they are hypocrites. The nearest people to the God are salvationary people. Salvationary people, they serve people and not kill people. Church of England people, when they die in the World War I, World War II, they said they glorify God. So what type of God was that? It was glorified by killing people. And salvation on people say they die for king and country, which is right. So many things are there. You will be astonished how people are stupid and made fool of by the book or media. So wake up and stand up. and raise your voice against atrocities and other things. Unrighteousness is of Satan, Hajimar al-Aqsa, highest city. So they are called super bastards. I usually call them in temple. In John 8, verse 44, that your forefathers are liars and super bastard magic devils. Now this word super bastard, they have removed it. And two reactions to this was that we are not born of illegitimate parents, we are born of legitimate parents. That was because he called them super bastards. So, Bible and other things, they are used as psychological tools. Psychic are dominating the world. Politicians are number one psychic. These hiring the color priests and churches, they are number two psychic. They can't give you account to God. So, how can the people give the account to God? The Queen herself, she can't enter the royal kingdom of God with so much money and other things. And how can people enter the church of our Supernatural Father? And then only they can learn something of their own, because they have desire, longing for gospel. Unless you have longing for gospel, you can't get it. So our Father God blesses everyone in agape, unconditional divine love.